cords I'm using, everything in this pile right here is 2 inches, or no, I'm sorry, two and a quarter. So you can see here where I used my, I'm trying to use those, I'm actually pre-drilling everything. These boards, actually a lot of this wood, can kind of rafter. I just want to do my screws here. I had these three temporary legs where, all right, so here we are. I won't put one screw in this so far, so I'm able to laying out where you put everything. Homemade. And there and there. All right, so I rounded off the edges of these pallets, down 4 feet long, and I need a little extra. So where I cut the length rails up in every single point, I have at least. So I'm starting this white. This is what I'm using, bare paint primer. They did recommend you to the wall in the kids' room. Okay, I climb over. That's going to be moved as well. That's the corner that the bed's going to be going in. All right. I ended up making a change. I originally had the ladder on the stop right there on this side. My son was climbing up last night, and since he didn't have anything to hold on to grip, he really kind of grabbed his sheet, or one of his sheets for his blanket or something, and he tried to pull himself up, and he almost fell back. So what I did was, I took off the shorter piece that was only 33 inches tall, but I added one that's all the way up to the top, that's 4 foot 7 inches, and I added a rail right here to match the other side. And now, he doesn't have trouble getting up or down. This feels a lot safer. Here are some pictures of the final product, and one of the pictures you can actually see is deep underneath. That's not the way that I layered, but actually painted. And anyway, I'm really glad with the way this bed turned out. He's actually really